Okay, guys, I'm here today with Nick Pollaro. He has a school here in the Indianapolis suburbs, and I'm gonna make a seminar here in his school tomorrow. Very excited about it. And Nick has a very interesting story because he's a retired police officer, and nowadays he teaches Jiu-Jitsu in the police academy, and he also teaches Jiu-Jitsu here in his school. So he does a great job teaching Jiu-Jitsu over there. And today I'm gonna ask him some questions like, why is Jiu-Jitsu so important for a police officer? So that's gonna be my first question to Nick. Like, Nick, why do you think like Jiu-Jitsu helps a lot for the police officer?
Well, Bernardo, it teaches officers to be under, when they're under pressure, they're under training, and they have somebody's in side control on them, or mount, puts a lot of pressure on them. And of course, when you're first learning Jiu-Jitsu, you know, you start panicking, and what do I do? And with Jiu-Jitsu, you know, you're able to slow things down, think things out, work your way out of the situation. So I think it's a good training environment without always putting gloves on and hitting each other. It's a good training environment to put pressure on it and work through hard, you know, work through hard areas put pressure on you, you'll make you work hard, breathe hard, that type of thing.
No, that's great. And you mentioned here like to create a scenario, right? So I agree with that because I think it's very hard to do a martial arts that you can go 100%. For example, if you do maybe karate or if you do Muay Thai or if you do boxing and you go 100%, man, also you're like over 30, over 35, over 40, you're gonna break yourself, you know? So I think that might help a lot because Jiu-Jitsu, you go 100% every day. So you really create that scenario that can happen on the street or anything like that. You agree? What do you think?
I would agree. Also, you know, when an officer has to arrest somebody, and if that person resists, a lot of times we have to take that person down to the ground. So obviously, Jiu-Jitsu helps with the takedowns. But more importantly, once we get the person down, we got to learn how to control the person. We got to know how to control the person. How do we get this person turned over to their stomach and put handcuffs on them? Jiu-Jitsu helps a lot with that aspect.
Yeah, that's great. Yeah, and I think like I don't know too much about like the rules about police officers, but I don't think you guys cannot punch and kick when you guys grab someone, right? How is it?
You know, it just depends on the circumstances and what's going on. A lot of times, we're trying not to hurt somebody, there's going to be times that, you know, Jiu-Jitsu is perfect for that because, again, we're able to grapple with them, get them under control. And, you know, the good thing is a lot of people, sometimes like you're striking, you know, breaking your hand or hurting yourself. So, again, Jiu-Jitsu is a good way to get somebody down, get control of them. Maybe no injury to you and also maybe no injury to the person.
Man, I agree 1,000% because as we just talked here, like, I can train with you and go 100%, go like as hard as I can, almost like the finals of the words, without hurting you. So that matches exactly what you said, because for example, you can grab someone, put him in the cuffs, put him on the ground, without even hurting him. I mean, I think a big example of that is like Demi Amaya, right? He wins all his UFC matches without hurting people and without hurting himself. That's awesome. So. And Nick, can I ask you, like, what's, in your opinion, like, the most used Jiu-Jitsu move for a police officer? Can you show us?
Yeah, sure.
There you go. Like, I believe there are a lot of techniques that you guys use and that you teach, but what's the one that you say, like, man, that's one of the main ones?
Well, why don't we show it, because it's very easy. In Jiu-Jitsu, or in police tactics, of course, we won't call it a submission, because we're trying to actually control the person and turn them over to a handcuffing position.
I got it.
So I'm going to put you out and I'm going to get them out.
Okay.
So we'll say that I was able to take you down, I was able to get you mounted. And here I am, and you know, there's a lot of resistance, you know, we get a lot of pushing and that thing. So a simple one that we show is, of course, the Americana or the figure four. And what we're doing here is, first we're gluing our thumbs to the sides, we're coming in, we're going to go 2-on-1. A lot of times, what officers do, they're trying to push down, and what I like to do is turn that elbow out where the person's a little weaker and then come down. And we're gonna get the figure four, okay? But what we're gonna add here is I'm gonna take you into a handcuffing position.
Okay.
So what I'm gonna do here is I'm gonna put enough pressure on you and tell you, open up your hand, open up your hand. So once you open up your hand, I'm gonna switch my grip and I'm gonna come into a handshake here.
Okay.
Now, if From there, I'm gonna do what we call a twist lock. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna come up, I'm gonna bring my hand towards me, but I'm gonna twist your pinky towards the mat.
Ah, man, that hurts.
Keep going.
Man.
All the way, get your other hand out where I can see it. Other hand out where I can see it. Okay. And I can go into a handcuffing position.
Man, that's awesome. I can imagine, like, for example, maybe I guess me that I do jiu-jitsu, I know jiu-jitsu, I would figure out a way to get out over there, but most of the guys don't do jiu-jitsu, right? So, man, that's awesome. One question, every time I teach self-defense, I'm not like a self-defense expert, right? I'm like a jiu-jitsu expert. So, but of course, because I do jiu-jitsu for a long time, I have a good idea for self-defense. So every time I teach self-defense, what I always try to teach is, for example, stand up, I always try to tell my students that, for example, if I'm fighting against you and I'm here, that's a dangerous situation for me that I do jiu-jitsu because you can punch me, you can kick me, and do that. So what I always try to do is stay away and then grab the person. For example, here we try the double leg or anything like that, because here's my work, right? Here's where we are good at. Then that's gonna be my question, and I'm gonna see your face. If I take the person down, because the fact that we are talking about self-defense, I don't want to exchange jiu-jitsu with the guy, because I always imagine, like, man, maybe this guy has like a bunch of partners, a bunch of friends, and then they start kicking me, or maybe they have a knife or anything like that. So I love the neon belly for self-defense. Because every time I'm on the ground, I'm not into street fight. I didn't have too many street fights in my life, only one or two when I was a kid. But I always try to imagine the situation. So for example, if I get here, I don't want to stay like this and then maybe have friends. I love the neon belly because it's a type of position that if the guy doesn't do jiu-jitsu, he's gonna feel really uncomfortable here because I have my knee on his diaphragm. And here I could punch his face if I wanted. I could hold him. I could call the police, joking. But, and I could, most important thing, if he has friends or this and that, I could easily like leave and run. So why do you think, because before we were talking, you told me that neon belly is one of your favorite moves. So
yeah, I think
give me your opinion.
Yeah, I think it's great for police officers to be able to do that, because again, if there's multiple suspects, they can scan the area, see what's going on, they get on the radio, call for help. One other thing I'd like to stress that we teach police officers is a lot of it is, like if they end up on their back, the biggest thing we try to teach is for them to get back up on their feet. You know, the guard and all that's all, you know, I think that's all great, but we have to worry out there in the street if there's a brick laying there or a broken bottle, if the person has a knife on them. So if I'm a police officer and I have the person in my guard, and they can access a weapon, and for
your control.
So what we try to stress is you need to get back up on your feet.
So neon belly matches with that, right? Because I can usually stand up and...
Absolutely. We want to try to teach them when they're in a compromised position, get back up. If they're in a position where they can go like neon belly or, you know, where they can get them, they can scan the area, watch for other suspects.
Oh, that's good to know that I'm teaching the right stuff. Thanks so much, Nick. I appreciate it. Thank you. Awesome.